In earlier chapter, we saw how we can perform some basic file operations like read, write, update, and delete. In this chapter, we will see more advanced file operation. So let's get started. In RPG, we do the file operations like read, update, delete on any specific record. To do the file operation on a specific record, we must set the file pointer on that record. To set the file pointer, we use SETLL or SETGT opcode. We will first start with SETLL opcode. SETLL or set lower limit opcode is used to set the file pointer at any specific record so that we can issue read operation on that particular record. While using the opcode SETLL, we use following entries. The first one is factor 1 entry. In factor 1, we can either specify RRN number or key value of the record that we want to read. SETLL opcode sets the file pointer on that specific record. For sequential file, we mention the RRN value in factor 1. Hence, if we enter 1 in factor 1, then the file pointer will be set at record number 1 in sequential file. For keyed access file, we use key field value in factor 1 instead of RN number. The pointer is set according to the key value provided in factor 1. Then we need to specify factor 2 entry. In factor 2, we specify the name of the file to set the pointer on that file. Let's start with some examples on how to set the file pointer. In this example, we will use the file account. This file has no key fields, that is, it is a sequential file. We also have a logical file account 1, where ACC, that is account number, is the key field. The data in the file account is as shown below. Now let's see how can we set the file pointer at the first record of sequential file account. As discussed earlier, for sequential file, we use RRN number in factor 1 with SETLL opcode to set the file pointer. Hence, to set the file pointer at the very first record of the file account, we use 1 as RRN number in factor 1. This is how the final statement looks like. When we run ever statement, file pointer will be set at the very first record of the file. Similarly, to set the file pointer at second record, we need to use 2 in factor 1. The statement will be as shown below. When we run above statement, file pointer will be set at second record of the file. Now let's see how can we set the file pointer for keyed file. For keyed access file, we must use key value in factor 1 along with SETLL opcode. In this example, we have account 1 logical file, which is a keyed file. Other than the key field value, we can also use star low val or star high val keyword in factor 1 to set the file pointer. We use star low val keyword in factor 1 to set the file pointer at the lowest key field value in the file, that is, to set the file pointer at the very first record of keyed file. Similarly, star high val is used to set the file pointer at the end of highest key field value. That is, it sets the file pointer at the end of last record in the file. Now let's see how can we set the file pointer at any specific record in the keyed file. To set the file pointer at any specific record, we must provide the key field value in factor 1. To provide the key field value in factor 1, we declare a variable in the program and then set a specific value in that variable. Then we enter the variable in factor 1. This is how the final code looks like. When we run above statements, it sets the file pointer at the record which has key field account number value as 1 10 times 0 4. Now we will discuss about opcode SETGT. SETGT or set greater than sets the file pointer to the record which has key field value greater than the value specified in factor 1. Let's see an example on how to set the file pointer at the end of third record. To set the file pointer at the end of third record, we can use SETGT opcode. First, we declare a variable and then we pass the key value of third record in that variable. Then we use this variable in factor 1 with SETGT opcode to set the file pointer at the end of third record. So this is how the final code looks like. When we run our statements, it sets the file pointer at the end of third record. Now once we have learned how to set the file pointer, we must also learn how to read the record where the file pointer is set. To read the record, we have various opcodes. Let's start with read opcode. Read opcode is used to read the record where the file pointer is. After reading the record, it moves the file pointer to the next record. In this example, we will do below steps. First, we will set the file pointer at the very first record in the file account using SETLL operation. Then we will check equal indicator in SETLL operation. If equal indicator is on, it means SETLL operation has found an equal or a matching record. Once the pointer is set at a matching record, we will read the record by using read opcode. Read opcode is used to read the record where the file pointer is. After reading the record, it moves the pointer to the next record. Then we can check the equal indicator in read operation. If equal indicator is off, it means the read operation is successful and we display the account number value. If equal indicator is on, it means read operation is unsuccessful and there is no records to read in the file. And it means it has reached the end of file condition. Let's go to IBM I server and understand the flow of the program. Let's save the program and then compile it. Run the program in debug mode now. The control comes to the very first statement where we use SETLL opcode. SETLL sets the file pointer at the first record. As discussed earlier, we use equal indicator or SETLL to check if the file pointer is set correctly or not. If it is on, it means the pointer is set at a matching record, that is at RN number equal to 1. Since this is a sequential file, we use RN number in factor 1. As we can see here, indicator 8 is on. It means we have found a matching record. Let's read the record now. To read the record, we use read opcode. On read operation, if equal indicator is off, it means the read operation is successful. But if it is on, it means we are at the end of the file and there are no records to read. As we can see here, indicator 8 is off. It means read operation is successful. Hence, we can display the account number value on the screen. Now let's see how the file pointer moves during the process. So in this example, when we execute the SETLL operation, then it sets the file pointer at the beginning of the record. Now when we issue read operation, it reads the first record and moves the pointer at the end of first record. Now if we issue a display operation on account field, it displays the account number which it has read just now. That is, it will display the first record. So this is how we use SETLL and read opcode together to read a record of the file. Now let's move on to another example. In this example, we will use keyed file and we will do read operation on the file. First, we declare the file account1, which is a keyed file or logical file based on account number key field. Then we set the file pointer at the end of second record. To set the file pointer at the end of second record, we use setgt opcode. Then we read the file and display the account value. Let's go to IBM iServer and see what we are doing in this program. Let's save the program and then compile it. Run the program in debug mode. The control goes to very first statement where we are initializing the variable kacc. Once we run the second statement, we have the variable account number value as 110.02. Now we use setgt to set the file pointer at the end of second record. It means the file pointer should be at third record. After setting the file pointer, we read the record using read opcode. Read operation is successful if equal indicator 80 is off. As we can see here, the indicator 80 is off, so the control will go to display operation now and account number value will be displayed on the screen. Now let's see how the file pointer moves during the process. When we execute setgt operation, it sets the file pointer at the end of second record, that is at the beginning of third record. Now when we issue a read operation, it reads third record and moves the file pointer at the end of third record. That is, it comes at the beginning of fourth record. Now if we issue a display operation on account field, it displays the account number value on the screen, which it has read just now. That is, third account number value will be shown on the screen. So this is how setgt and read operation works together in the example. Now let's move on to next example. In this example, we will see how we can read more than one record in the file. Let's understand what we are doing in the program. In below example, we use SETLL opcode to set the file pointer at the first record of the key file account. After SETLL, we perform the read operation. If SETLL operation fails in case there is no record in the file, then following read operation will set the file pointer at the end of file. It means indicator 80 will be on and we will not be able to enter the do while loop, and thus the program ends. If the first read operation is successful, then it will read the first record and will move the file pointer to second record. If we issue second read operation, it will read second record and will move the file pointer to third record. So this is how the process goes on. After each successful read operation, it sets the equal indicator off. It will set the equal indicator on only if end of file condition is reached. That is, there are no more records to read in the file. Hence, we keep on reading the file until equal indicator is on. When indicator 80 is on, we come out of the loop and the process ends. Let's see the flow of the program. When we execute the setll operation, it sets the file pointer at the beginning of first record. Now when we issue a read operation, it reads first record and moves the file pointer at the beginning of second record. Now if we issue a display operation in account field, it displays the account number value on the screen that we have read just now. That is, first account number value. Since we are in do while loop, another read operation is issued and it reads second record and moves the file pointer to third record. The display operation displays the second account number value now. Likewise, on third read operation, it reads third record and moves the file pointer to fourth record. Then the display operation displays the third account number value that we have read just now. On fourth read operation, it reads fourth record and moves the pointer to fifth record. Then the display operation displays the fourth account number value that we have read just now. On fifth read operation, it reads the fifth record and moves the pointer at the end of fifth record. Then the display operation displays the fifth account number value. On next read operation, we don't have any records to read. Hence, the read operation will be unsuccessful and indicator 80 will be on. Since indicator 80 is on, it means end of file condition is reached and we come out of the loop. Now let's move on to next example.